Greetings, greetings, greetings. Good afternoon and welcome to AP Today, the show where you are inspired, informed, motivated, encouraged, and even entertained at times. Today's topic and those I have shared this week are excerpted from my column. I truly appreciate all the positive feedback from you viewers. Thank you very much for staying with us every day. This week has turned into Story Week, and though money is a topic that I do not really share on, today's story is definitely worthy of passing on. So, the topic for today, for I&I, Inspiration and Insights and Inspiration, is money is like water. I am not sure that my guest today will agree, but here goes. Lynn Twist is the founder of Pachamama Alliance and the author of Soul of Money, from which the following story is quoted. And she says, "I learned a lot about money from a woman named Gertrude. I met her in a church basement in Harlem. I was doing a small fundraising event for the Hunger Project after coming from Minneapolis, where I had met with an executive of a large food company. The food company had an image problem and felt that making a donation to the Hunger Project and being seen to support the end of hunger might help clean up its image. The executive I met with had given me a check for $50,000, but he gave me the donation basically to get me to go away, to ease his guilt about some public mistakes the company had made, and to have the company look good in the eyes of the public. I had the $50,000 check in my briefcase, which sat behind me on a table in the basement of the Harlem Church. There were 75 people gathered before me. It was raining, and there were leaks all over the room we were in. There were buckets strategically placed all around us, catching the dripping water, and there was a constant background noise of the rain outside and the dripping from the leaking walls and ceiling. I looked out at the audience and I knew that the people sitting there did not have much to give. I spoke to them about the Hunger Project's work in Africa, as I thought it would be the most relevant to their own lives and their heritage. When it came time to ask for donations, my palms were sweating and I began to perspire all over, wondering if it was the right thing to do. I went ahead and made the request, and the room was absolutely silent. After what seemed like a long, long time, a woman named Gertrude stood up. She was sitting on the aisle in the second row from the back. She was in her late 60s or early 70s. She had gray hair, and when she stood up, she was tall, thin, erect, and proud. And she said to me, "I ain't got no checkbook. I ain't got no credit cards. To me, money is a lot like water. For some folks, it rushes through their life like a raging river. But the money comes through my life like a small trickle. But I want to pass it on in a way that does the best good for the most folks. I see that as my right and as my responsibility. It's also my joy. I have $50 in my purse that I earned from doing a white woman's wash, and I want to give it to you." She walked up the aisle and gave me her precious $50. And at that moment, I saw the power of money in a new way. I knew that the $50 that I received from Gertrude would buy more for the end of hunger than the $50,000 check in my briefcase. I knew that $50 was money that came from the soul and not just from some bank account. I saw that the power of money can be seen in the way we use it and the integrity with which we direct it into the world. Gertrude taught me a great lesson, and I never forgot it. As Gertrude tells us, we can look at money like water. It flows all over the planet, and everywhere it goes, it's useful. It makes things happen, and it's passed along. We could say that water doesn't belong to any of us, or it belongs to all of us. When water is flowing and moving, it cleanses, it purifies, it makes things green, it creates growth, it nurtures. But when water starts to slow down, is held back, and starts to be still, it can be toxic and stagnant to those who hold it. All of this can be true of money. It's possible to have money flow in a way that serves our highest ideals and commitments rather than accumulate it so that we can gain power, authority, and special privileges over others. Money can bear the mark of he or she who passed it on, and in many ways can be the voice, expression, and commitment. I trust that sharing today would have given you some food for thought. And I would like to just share with you that today on the program, my guest, Mr. Garth Thomas, will be sharing on, guess what? Money. So we will be right back after the break. And welcome back. My guest today has been on set before, and so he's no stranger to us. Mr. Garth Thomas is an independent financial advisor and will be a regular featured guest on AP Today as of today. So you can look out for him on Thursdays. Welcome.
Delighted to be here, AP.
Wonderful. And I am thrilled to tell you that quite a few people were looking forward to today with you and what you're going to share about prerequisites for personal financial planning. It's all yours.
Prerequisites. Personal financial planning.
I might take some notes.
Feel free, and everybody should.
Yes.
All right. I just wanted to underline a couple things in that title.
Yes.
Prerequisites. Pretty straightforward.
Yes.
Yes? Before you begin a process, there are things that you need to put in place.
You must know
in order
what they
for things
are.
To happen. So before I get down into any sort of details about this, that, or the other, I thought that it was necessary to identify prerequisites.
Yes.
I cannot guarantee that we are going to be able to cover all the prerequisites in this program.
No, but you're back next week. Yes.
That's all right.
Wonderful.
Okay? So it's prerequisites.
Yes.
Secondly, it is about personal financial planning. Now, personal financial planning is distinct from corporate finance.
Yes.
Yes, it's about personal financial planning. It's about the individual managing the money that he has control over.
Okay.
All right? Or gaining control over the money he has.
Yes.
Whichever way you want to put it. All right? So it's personal. I make that distinction because a lot of people, when they hear that I give advice in terms of finance, I get calls for all kinds of financial advice.
I know
that I am not really qualified to give.
Okay.
You know, especially in the area of corporate finance.
Yes.
Corporate finance
is a different
thing. Special field.
Yes.
It is different from personal.
Mm-hmm.
I am more focused on the issue of personal financial planning.
Good.
So I wanted to make that clear from the outset.
Good.
All right. Now, if we go down the title, it's personal,
mm-hmm.
it's financial, which means that it has to do about money.
Yes.
And it is planning.
Yes.
So if we're going to talk about prerequisites, what I want to start with is the prerequisites for planning, period.
Okay.
All right. And then we look at how it applies to finance.
Good.
And to personal finance.
Wonderful.
Yes?
I like that. You sound like a teacher.
Well, they say that
that's what you do.
I was
supposed to do. Okay.
Maybe it's my calling. I'm
yes.
not too sure. But
you know,
there are different ways
that
you teach.
You teach. Yeah.
All right. So let's talk then about the planning process.
Mm-hmm.
And there are two specific, at least two, that's what I'm going to deal with, at least two aspects of the planning process.
Good.
There is the mechanics of planning, and there is the dynamics of planning.
Okay.
All right?
So this is
mechanics,
the order that we're going in.
And dynamics.
Okay, good.
And they need to be, now they are integrated in the process, but we need to be aware that there are those two different elements that impact the process. Yes?
Wonderful.
So when I was here last, mm-hmm. I talked about a template for planning your finances. And I identified three lines: the finish line, the start line, and the timeline.
Yes.
Yes? That's part of the mechanics
okay.
of the process.
Mm-hmm.
And I perhaps want to give a little more information.
Yes,
on
especially
those
for people who would not have seen you the last time that you
right.
were here. Good.
Okay.
Yes.
So what I said the last time was that, you know, the planning process begins with the finish line. It doesn't begin with the start line, which seems to be the logical place for it to start. Implementation of the plan will begin at the start line. But setting the plan up must begin at the finish line.
Mm-hmm.
Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Stephen Covey, in his book, Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, spoke about that. He says you must begin with the end in mind. It's a principle for planning.
Is that like a
begin
goal?
Begin with the end in mind.
Yes.
So, yes, that's about goals.
Goals.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
But my favorite, I can't remember if I gave this illustration in the last program, but I think it bears repeating. A lady wakes up a Saturday morning, bathes, dresses, goes down to the supermarket.
Mm-hmm.
She buys some eggs, some flour, some sugar, some vanilla essence,
some dry fruit. You can bake, huh?
don't test me.
Okay.
All
okay.
right. What do you think she has in mind?
She's
going to bake a cake
yes.
or sweet bread,
yep.
all right?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously,
mm-hmm.
because of what she has selected.
Mm-hmm.
So the question is, at what point did she decide that is what she wanted to do? Quite likely she had decided on it the day before or sometime during the week. She said, weekend are going to
bake a cake, yes.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
So when she woke up that Saturday morning, she had a specific end
in mind. Gotcha.
All right? And that specific end informed her behavior
next
on that Saturday morning.
Yes.
Because she could have awakened on that Saturday morning and said, ah, it's Saturday. I don't have to go to work today. I could sleep late. And she could have turned over. And next thing you know, it's 12 o'clock. And by the time she make two turns, Saturday finish.
Yes.
Yes. But she had a specific end in mind.
Yes.
And the end was that she had to bake today.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, it guided her actions throughout that day.
Yes.
All right? So you always begin with the end in mind, because where you want to reach is going to require particular behaviors if that goal is to be achieved. All right? So the planning process, whether it is your finance, your career, whatever.
Even what you're going to wear on a daily basis, you must know, yes. I'm going to go this way, correct. So I have to.
Yeah, okay. Yes. So you must decide on the finish line. Where do I want to end up? What do I want to achieve?
What am I
that
doing?
Is the
yes.
first
what am I going to be? Yes.
That you have to do. The second thing is to identify the resources you currently have available. Mm-hmm. That's your starting line. Whatever resources you have available today is where you begin. All right? You cannot work with what you don't have. It's impossible. You all know that.
Repeat but that, please.
You cannot work with what you don't have. All right? It seems, you know, so obvious.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, when you look at behavior, you find people spend a lot of their time wishing that they had and saying, if I had, I would have. Yes? That's a place where a lot of people live. And it is really an excuse for inaction.
Yes.
Some people would call it laziness.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd say it's an excuse for not taking action.
Yes.
Yes? So you need to know what are the resources that you have currently. Now, part of that problem of identifying that start line is that a lot of people don't feel that they have much resources.
Is it because a lot of us think that resources has only to do with money?
Correct. People tend to look at material resources.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. More than the intangibles.
Yes.
And in my experience of life, and you know, that this is part of prerequisites.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to come back to that
yes.
at another stage, which yes. is a question of understanding the nature of the universe in which we live.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're going to be planning your finances in a particular context.
Okay.
And the context is determined by the nature of the universe.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you do not understand, I keep saying, telling people, if you do not understand the field of play in the game of life, how can you expect to win the game? You know, it's just like, you know, CPL going on now.
Yes.
All right? If rain falls, it is going to affect the field of play.
Yes.
The strategy that you're going to employ, well, you know, perhaps with CPL, it really don't matter too much. You go with CPL, you know, you're hitting sixes, but it might affect your ability to score fours,
yes.
which are also important.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but my point is you need to know the nature of the field of play. But we're gonna come back to that. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So that is part of the prerequisites, which that need a whole program by itself.
We have you know, God willing, all the Thursdays to come. I think.
Okay. So I'm saying though that you need to identify the start line is about identifying resources that are right now available to you.
What do
something
I have?
That you can work with.
What do I have in my hand?
Yes, what do I have in my hand? You know, one of the translations for the 23rd Psalm is, because the Lord is my shepherd, I have everything that I need.
Okay.
All right? Well, you know, the old King James translation is, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Well, you know, it's saying the same thing perhaps,
okay.
but in different terms. I have everything that I need. So it is really asking us to look and see what we have. Rhonda Byrne, don't know if you know the name, Rhonda Byrne, who wrote The Secret.
Mm-hmm.
She has also written some other books.
Yes,
one of them
the
is
one
The Magic.
Popular form. Mm-hmm.
And The Magic talks about the power of thankfulness.
Or gratitude.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. You know,
mm-hmm.
you talk about the gratitude rock and those kinds
yeah.
of things. And that is relevant mm-hmm. because not only do you need to recognize the resources that you have, but you need to be thankful for them.
Yes.
Because if you're not thankful for them, it's impossible to use them.
Mm-hmm.
All right? You have to say, aha, I have something to work with. Thank you, Jesus. So, you know, if Jesus is not your thing,
oh God.
It's mine, but
yes.
you know, you need to be thankful to God
yes.
for what you have. So now you have, you know where you want to go, mm-hmm. the finish line. Mm-hmm. You know where you are standing today.
Right.
The resources that you currently have available to you to utilize.
Yes.
So you have two of the three lines
taken
that care. Require the as a prerequisite for mm-hmm. the planning process.
Yes.
Okay. The third line is the timeline.
Yes.
All right. And that is where you need to decide on some timelines. You need to decide how long do I want to take to get from where I am
to where
I want to go.
Okay.
Yes. So now you decide on that. Now, in terms of financial planning, mm-hmm. my recommendation is a minimum, and you know I like to underline these words, minimum meaning the shortest time that you should work with mm-hmm. is 10 years.
Depending on the size of the goal?
Yeah, well, you see, there's a law that says that work expands to fill the time allocated for its completion.
Okay.
Yes? So it means the more time you give yourself
okay.
is the longer it's going to take. But at the same time, you have to balance that with your willingness to pay the price because there's a cost to achieving any goal. Mm. It means that you have to ignore certain things, give up certain things, and do some things that you would not normally do. All of that is part of the price mm-hmm. that one pays in order to achieve a goal.
Yes.
Any kind of goal. Mm-hmm. Yes, I mean, if you're an athlete, all right, you want to get up to a particular speed.
Some people call it sacrifices. Bolt.
Yes, sacrifice is a word that is appropriate.
Yes.
All right? But you want to get somewhere, you have to give something up. You have to give something to it.
Okay.
All right? So in terms of the timeline, I am saying, in the context of personal financial planning, though,
okay,
all right,
you set a time, a 10-year period.
10 years.
A 10-year period is what we need to look at.
And if I will go so far as to say that even if at this present moment you are deep in debt, all right, and you set a goal to be a multimillionaire in 10 years, mm-hmm. it is doable.
Okay. Repeat that. Can you repeat that, please?
I'm saying that even if you are deep in debt,
yes.
if you engage the process that I'm outlining,
yes.
even if you are deep in debt, in 10 years' time, you can move from being deep in debt to being a multimillionaire.
Okay, I'll tell you why.
And you don't need to sell drugs.
Uh-huh. Good. The reason I asked you to repeat it is because what most of us do is look at the fact that we are deep in debt. And not at the possibility, yes, I can.
Precisely.
Yeah.
And as long as you are preoccupied, you see, now we're getting bunged down into the other kind of prerequisites, eh? Because one of the resources that is available mm-hmm. to every one of us
yes.
on the planet is the mind. Okay? And the mind. You know, we probably gonna need several sessions to talk about the mind.
Well, like I said, you'll be back.
All right.
God willing,
but the mind is a primary resource.
Yes.
And the paradox of that is that even though the mind is a primary resource, and even though everybody has a mind, although sometimes you wonder, but even though everybody has one.
Yes.
Okay. It is one of the most underutilized
yes, yes.
resources mm-hmm. that every human being has.
I agree okay? with you, yes.
And when I talk about the mind, I am talking about the whole mind, meaning the conscious mm-hmm. and the unconscious or subconscious mind.
Okay.
Now, the one that people really don't pay attention to sufficiently is the subconscious mind.
Okay.
And that is why most people live very powerless lives, because the power to have dominion
over,
which is a God-given power, mm-hmm. is resident in the subconscious mind.
Okay.
Now, when you define the subconscious, as that which is operates below the level of our awareness, mm-hmm. then you begin to understand where there's a problem.
Okay. So hold it right there. No, no, we have to go to break.
Okay,
yes?
Sure.
So when we come back from the break, we will continue this discussion about money.
Money.
Money. We'll be right back. And welcome back to the show where you are informed. Today we're talking about a very important topic, and that is managing your personal finances. And my guest today is Mr. Garth Thomas. So before the break, you were touching on something, but if you will, in case somebody would have just joined us, just do a little recap, please.
All right. So we said that we were going to look at some of the prerequisites for personal financial planning.
Yes.
And I said that there were two elements to that. One was the mechanics of personal financial planning.
Yes.
And the second is the dynamics.
Okay.
Well, we haven't really gotten into the dynamics as yet. We're dealing with the mechanics
first.
Although you will note that as we go along, the dynamics keep
yes.
coming in. Because you really cannot separate the two. All right. The thing is that knowing the mechanical steps, the 1, 2, 3, to plan does not in itself guarantee that planning will take place.
1, 2, 3 steps?
Yes. All right, the three lines, like
yes.
I said, the three lines. You know, the finish line, the start line,
yes.
and the timeline.
I was thinking if anybody just joined us,
right.
they would have gotten that.
So we spoke about those things.
Yes.
You begin with the end in mind, which is that you set your goal.
Mm-hmm.
What's the finish line? What do you want to achieve? Then you check your current resources, the resources that are available to you right now to begin to work with.
Yes.
Because you don't want to have a plan that you're going to begin to implement tomorrow
mm-hmm.
or next week. You want to begin now because the timeline kicks in there because you have a specified frame work of time within which you want to achieve the particular goal. And, you know, procrastination, they say, is the thief of time.
Yes.
And when you begin to say, well, tomorrow I will begin.
And then tomorrow comes.
You're off on the wrong foot
yes.
immediately. Because tomorrow, who has control over tomorrow?
That's
you
right.
don't know what's going to happen between now and tomorrow.
Or even tonight.
Anything that is important to achieve deserves
now
that you begin to do something about it.
Right now.
You begin to take action now.
Yes.
Right? But you don't want to take action in a vacuum, which is why I've set up the frame that you identify where you want to go, the finish line. You identify the resources that are currently available, which is your start line.
Yes.
And you set a timeline.
Good.
And that timeline should begin now.
Right.
Today.
Yes.
Yes?
But you did put a caption time on it.
Yes.
For
so
achieving.
I said the time, mm-hmm. minimum being the least amount of time you should select, especially in the context of a financial goal.
Yes.
Should be 10 years.
Good.
And I did say that even if you are deep in debt now, and you see that's why when the conversation went into the issue of people who are deep in debt now cannot see beyond
yeah,
the debt.
That's right.
As long as you cannot see beyond your debt,
that's where you stay.
That is where you're going to stay because that is how the mind works.
Yes.
And the mind is the creator, especially the subconscious mind, mm-hmm. is creates your future. And the question of self-talk, now I see self-talk again, that's a psychological issue.
Yes, but we understand
right?
the principles.
But it is, yeah, the self-talk thing. Mm-hmm. Well, you see, I think people do not really understand the power of self-talk, right? Because self-talk is that conversation that goes on inside your head 24/7.
Yes.
And my definition of it is this. You know, there's a fancy thing called neuro-linguistic programming,
okay.
NLP,
okay.
which refers to self-talk.
Yes.
I like to say that self-talk is the zoom lens of the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
You could quote that one.
I will.
Self-talk is the zoom lens of the mind because it is that conversation that focuses the subconscious mind. Mm-hmm. And if your self-talk is just engaged in how many people you owe, how much you owe, how you, you know, then
that's where you stay.
You're thinking about debt, you create debt.
Yes.
Right, you continue
what
to
we think
debt.
We attract. Yeah. Yes, yeah, what we focus on, we attract.
Correct.
Right, the more
so
of
the issue of focus is critical.
All right. So what's next?
So once we understand that those are the prerequisites.
Yes.
That you need to have a clear-cut goal, that you need to be aware of what your current resources are, and you need to consciously set a timeline. Mm-hmm. Then you have the basic elements for the planning process.
Okay.
And you need that for any kind of plan you're going to make, but you need it especially for your finances.
Good.
Okay?
Let me just interrupt you to remind the viewers that you can feel free to call in and pose a question to Mr. Thomas. Yes.
Yes, and mm-hmm. I will answer it to
the best of your ability.
Let me quickly say that I don't pretend to know all there is to know about personal financial planning.
That's okay.
I'll just share out of my own experience
and knowledge, yes.
And so on.
Yes.
Okay, so we have the goal. Now, let us talk about that finish line.
Okay.
There are two things you have to be careful about in setting a goal. And again, this refers to any goal, mm-hmm. but it refers especially to your financial goals. You should not set a financial goal that is too low.
Okay.
Yes? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Why? Question is, why not? And I will say very quickly that if the goal you set does not excite you,
this is in the acquisition of money.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Okay. If, well, you know, it is the money and what money can buy.
Yeah.
Yes. So if the goal does not excite you, then the odds are that you will not, you could do up the most beautiful of plans.
You're not going to get up and go.
Whether or not you're going to implement it is questionable.
That's right.
All right. So the goal should not be a goal that you can achieve without any effort.
Yeah.
What's the value of that?
Right.
Yes. By the same token, the goal should not be so big that whenever you look at it,
you scare yourself.
You begin to wonder whether you can meet it. All right?
You doubt yourself. Yes.
Right. Self-doubt. You don't want to engage self-doubt at all, because that would definitely derail
that's the end
any
of that.
Plan that
right.
you have.
That's the end of that, yeah.
So you want to strike a balance. And you want to use a faculty that has been given to you by the Almighty. All right? And that is the faculty of your imagination.
Mm.
Okay? Imagination rules the world.
Yes. Because that's where everything starts. Yes?
You imagine your capacity. If you cannot imagine, let us bring it down into our financial. If you cannot imagine being wealthy,
I know.
You
and what it feels like.
Yeah.
What it would look like.
What it would look like, what it would feel like.
Yes.
Okay? If you cannot imagine that, then odds are you will never be wealthy.
So imagine yourself in the house that you dream about, driving the car that you dream about, etc.
Yes.
Yes.
You have to use your imagination.
Mm-hmm.
All right? The imagination is what allows you to break free from all of the limitations that keeping you where you are.
But some people start to imagine and they shut it down. No.
Well, you see,
there's a difference between wishing and using your imagination.
Well, perhaps wishing is an early stage, but you cannot leave it at wishing.
Right.
If you just wish it, then, you know, think
right.
But, you know, but we're getting into the question of
that's
the mind
another thing,
and
yes.
the utilization
of the
mind.
But we want to stay with
right?
this, yes.
So I'm saying, though, that you need to be careful in setting a goal, but the goal must be specific.
Mm-hmm.
All right? To say that you want to have plenty money is not a goal.
So we want
it's
to
too ambiguous.
Set
it's
a figure.
Yes, you need to set a figure. You need to say, I want to have $1 million.
By?
Right. Or $10 million or $100 million. Mm-hmm. really doesn't matter.
But we must have the
amount.
Timeline attached
yes.
to it.
Yes, you must have the timeline. But the amount must be an amount that you can believe that
it's
you
possible.
Will achieve.
Because
mm-hmm. you have to remember that the goal is not something that is set in concrete.
Yes.
All right? And remember, I said it is personal financial planning. So it is a goal that has to be personal to you.
Yes.
That has meaning for you. Mm-hmm. That excites you when you think about it.
Okay.
It may not do that for anybody else. That is all right. It's not their goal.
This is
it's
about
not their
your
plan.
Personal
this
finances.
This is about you. So it has to be something that is meaningful to you.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And I just give the caution that don't set a goal that is too low and
or
don't set a
high.
Goal that is too high.
Okay.
In truth and in fact, when you begin to utilize the power of your subconscious mind, you will begin to realize that the size of the goal is neither here nor there. All right? Because the mind's capacity for creating that future reality is not limited.
Mm-hmm.
Did I ever give you my acrostic? I did an acrostic for mind.
Mm.
Did I ever share it with you?
I don't think so.
Right, maybe I should keep it for the prerequisites for,
next,
for the dynamics.
Yeah, next week.
Oh, just Bring teasing it. People.
Yeah. Oh, something to look forward to next Thursday.
I will give it to you because I'm going to keep coming back to it.
Okay.
Because it is fundamental to the process.
Good enough.
The mind is a magnificent. M for magnificent.
Yes.
I for infinitely intelligent. N for nuclear powered.
Good.
And I will amplify each of these things
yes.
in time. Nuclear powered. So magnificent, infinitely intelligent, nuclear powered. D is for dynamo.
Love it.
All right. Now, you know a dynamo is a power generator.
That's right.
Okay?
That's right.
God made us in his own image. We could talk a lot about that. And like after his own likeness and gave us dominion
mm-hmm.
over the planet.
Okay. Now,
right? But we kind of...
Yeah, because, you know, I know some people are sitting... Waiting to hear you start to talk dollars and cents, but that's
yeah,
this.
That's
the
don't worry
normal,
about the mechanics.
That's right.
Mechanics
that's gonna come
once you have here.
Yes.
Okay.
That's
now, so
come.
So in terms of the planning process, if we mm-hmm. go back into the planning process.
Yes.
Having set the finish line, you plan backward. You don't plan forward.
Mm-hmm.
You execute forward.
Okay.
But you plan backward.
Say that again, please.
All right. So. Having established the finish line,
right.
then you begin to plan backward. So
yes.
if I go back to my illustration with the lady in the grocery,
uh-huh.
right, going to the grocery, the lady, the process would have been that she decides that she wants to bake
cake.
All right? And she says, when am I going to bake it? Saturday.
Right.
So that's the time.
Mm-hmm.
What will I need to bake this cake?
Yeah, so we're going this way.
All right? So she knows she has to go
to the
grocery. She knows she, well, even before that, she knows she has to have all of the requirements necessary to bake a cake. So the last step before the cake, all right, comes into being.
Yes.
All right? Remember, mm-hmm. the cake is the end result.
Yes.
All right? So the process comes back. What if the end result is the cake? Then the step immediately before that is not the acquisition of the required
mm-hmm.
Materials.
Right.
The step immediately before that is when it comes out of the oven. All right. So you could say that the step just before that goal is going to be achieved would be the placing of the batter.
The ingredients.
The batter, yeah.
Yes.
The batter created by the
mm-hmm,
ingredients
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
into the oven.
Mm-hmm.
Because that is the last step.
I see what you're saying, yes.
So as the last step. The step mm-hmm. before that now may be the preparation of the pan.
Okay.
Into which the batter is going to be poured.
Told you could bake, but we got to go to break. We will be right back after the break to continue with this discussion about finances. We're almost out of time.
Yeah.
Yes. And welcome back. Mr. Garth Thomas is sharing with us today about prerequisites for personal financial planning.
Correct. And we've outlined the planning process, that one needs to be aware of the planning process.
Yes.
In order to make an effective plan.
Uh-huh.
And my plan, the plans that I've recommended, which I've tried to make it as simple as possible for people to be able to grasp, is that you need
Thank
to have
you
a finish
so much.
Line, a start line, and a timeline.
Yes.
Yes? And I was talking about the cake, baking the cake, that you're planning backward.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So immediately there's an assumption that you're going to achieve the goal.
Yes.
And you say, where will I be just before I achieve the goal? Mm-hmm. And in the context of the lady baking the cake, I'm saying that would be the step immediately before baking. Before getting the cake,
yes.
It's putting it into the oven, the preparing the pan, preparing the batter. You see how you're coming back? Preparing the batter, getting the materials,
mm-hmm.
Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Going to get the materials,
mm-hmm.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
Getting ready to go and get the materials.
Gotcha, I gotcha.
It's not complicated.
No.
It's a process, all right? So
that is how
you plan it.
Yeah. These are things that we do on a daily basis and
Correct.
Probably take it for granted.
Exactly.
But it's the same All right. principle that is applied.
In terms of managing your finances.
Okay, good.
All right. So those are essentially the mechanics
Yes.
of the planning process.
Uh-huh.
Now the dynamic of the planning process is where you engage the resources. It's a question of developing a strategy
mm-hmm.
or strategies.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now you have a plan, which is one thing, and a strategy, which is a different thing. The plan is those basic steps that you say, step one, step two, step three, step four, or in terms of what I've outlined, you say step four, step three, step two, step one. All right, that is the plan. How am I going to go about implementing this plan?
Right.
Requires a strategy, a modus operandi, a way of approaching getting the thing done.
Yes.
Okay? So you have to develop strategies. Now you hear people talk about plan A and plan B.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, in my book, really, and I could be wrong. I always allow for the fact that I could be wrong. But it seems to me that it is more necessary to have strategy A
mm-hmm.
and strategy B.
Okay.
And strategy C, all right? Because I'm going to try to achieve the goal by approaching it in this particular way, by mobilizing the resources that I have in
have
a particular
available.
Way
mm-hmm.
to bring out a particular result.
Mm-hmm.
But if when I implement that, when I start to do that, and I check progress and performance and so on, I see it's not working, then I have to check myself and mm-hmm. say, look, I overlooked something. There was something which I did not calculate for. I need to re-strategize.
Mm-hmm.
I need to come up with a different approach.
Okay.
Yes? So you have when it comes now to developing the strategy,
mm-hmm.
that is one element of the dynamics.
Yes.
But the more important element of the dynamics is the self-motivation.
Hmm.
All right? Because, you know, you can say, I can. That has become very popular. Obama, I can.
But will you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The question is,
will you?
All right? And you have to say, because I can, I will.
Do what is necessary.
I will, because I want. You see? So it's I can, I will, I want. Okay?
Because I want.
Yeah, okay? Because I want, I will. And I will because I know I can.
Okay.
The issue of self-esteem, the issue of my self-confidence,
mm-hmm. comes into
that I can achieve what I set out to achieve.
Mm-hmm.
That's all part of the dynamics.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we live in the age of Google. I know we're running out of time, so I'm going to end on this.
Mm-hmm.
We live in the age of Google. Now, we have to learn to Google the most fantastic database of information that is available to us. And it's not our computer, it is our mind. One of the first organs that develops within the human fetus is the brain. Now, the mind is bigger than the brain,
mm-hmm.
but the brain is the hard drive
mm-hmm.
of the mind.
Okay.
Yes?
Yes.
I think I should say that again because people have confused brain and mind. A brain is a part of the mind, but the mind is not restricted to the brain.
Okay.
But the brain is an integral part of it.
Okay.
It is what I call in computer technology,
mm-hmm.
I say is the hard drive.
Okay.
Okay? So that hard drive, from since you were in your mother's womb, has been absorbing information of all kinds,
mm-hmm.
by all means, visually, audially, you know, it's just going on,
mm-hmm.
all right? So that each of us, at this moment, possesses a database of information that is huge.
Okay.
It is absolutely awesome in terms of all the tasks.
So bring that home to the topic for today.
All right. Well, because remember that the start line, one of the resources that we identified in the start line,
yes.
is your mind.
Good.
All right. And I'm saying now that you have all of this information in your mind.
Yes.
The question isn't whether or not you have the information. Remember, for instance, sometimes you meet somebody and you can't remember their name. That's not a proper way to put it. Actually, you should say you cannot recall the name.
Yes.
Because the name is there.
Mm-hmm.
But for whatever reason, you cannot recall it. And the more you struggle to recall it, is the less likely it is you to recall it. But if you let go of it and you turn your mind to something else, after a little while, the name pops into your minds. Okay. So that tells us that even though there's information within, that our ability to access that information gets into trouble, that we get into trouble with it, okay? So that's why I talk about Googling your mind. And quickly what I want to say is that there's a question that you have to ask yourself repeatedly in order to create a particular mindset.
Okay. As
yes?
it regards your finances. As
with regard to any goal that you set.
Okay.
With regard to any goal that you set. Having set the goal,
yes.
having identified your resources and set the timeline, you ask the question, how can I? That's the question. Not can I. Can I is a promoter of self-doubt.
Mm-hmm.
Can I do this? You could debate that issue for the rest of your life,
yes.
and don't come up with a proper conclusion.
Okay, so the good news is,
the good news is that if you begin to ask, if you keep asking the question, and you see remember I said the mind is an infinitely intelligent
yes.
mechanism.
Okay.
Okay, so the question you are asking your mind all the time is, how can I achieve this goal that I have set? Using the resources that I have identified
yes.
within the time frame that I have set for the achievement of this goal.
Wonderful.
And all right? And if you can't ask that question once AP.
Okay.
You have to keep asking that question over and over and over again as often as you think about the goal. It helps you to stay focused on the goal,
mm-hmm.
but it is also activating a search engine that is superior to Google to pull from your mind
yes.
the answers, the strategies. Because if we come back to the thing there, is the strategies that you have to implement. You get, you know what you call them? Ideas.
Okay. So that is the note that we will close on today.
Okay.
So
fair
we're going to.
Yes, it's 3 o'clock already.
So is it safe to say that we can start next week's program with ideas as
power of an idea.
The power of an idea. And we want to keep reminding people that this is also about financial.
It's prerequisites for personal. Remember, I said it's prerequisites
for personal.
So people who are waiting to hear how to do a budget and a cash flow statement.
Not yet.
No, not yet. Those things, we ain't getting into that yet.
All right. So thank you so much.
It was my pleasure.
Yes. Thank you very much. And this is where I remind you that weak faith panics, growing faith prays. However, seasoned faith walks on water in the midst of the storms. Thank you so much for staying with us today. We look forward to yet another wonderful program tomorrow. We have something totally different, exciting planned for you tomorrow. So come on by. Again, I thank my guest for today, Garth Thomas. Lots and lots of information. Much love to you.